In a previous tutorial video, we went over what a button symbol is and how to create it. And a button symbol is one of three symbols, but it has a very unique purpose. Its purpose is to have somebody click on it and it's going to do something. The other two types of symbols are a movie clip symbol and a graphic symbol. Now, both of these symbols are very similar in that they both have internal timelines and they can help you create more complex animation. But there are some differences. So in this video, we're going to talk about how to create a movie clip symbol and a graphic symbol, and then what their differences are and when you might choose to use one over the other. So let's go ahead and start by looking at a movie clip that's already created. If I wanted to move this bird from the left of the stage to the right of the stage, I could, but it's just going to stay in this one position if this wasn't a movie clip. So in order to get it to move from the left to the right, plus have all of these different versions of it so it looks like he's actually flying, I'd have to create a really long and complex frame by frame animation. And I don't want to do that. So instead, I created a movie clip symbol, which you can see here, and it looks the exact same as the graphic symbol bird one, but that's just because the first frame in the movie clip symbol's timeline is this graphic bird one. So I'll double click on the movie clip, and you can see now we're in the movie clip MC bird, and now you can see that frame by frame animation. But I only had to do it once, because in a movie clip, the timeline will keep looping just like a regular animation unless you add action script to stop it. So as we go through each one of these, on frame one, I added the graphic symbol of bird one. On frame two, I added graphic symbol of bird two, three, three, four, four. And so it's kind of like the old paper animations where you created a flip book with it. And what I did was lined up the eyeballs so that we would get a smooth animation. So if we watch this, I'll hit return or enter on my keyboard, and that's one loop of that animation. And because I didn't add stop action script, this internal movie clip timeline is just going to keep looping. So he's going to keep flying until I tell him to be off this stage or I delete him in my animation. So I'll go back to scene one. Now here's the tricky part. If you're looking here, I have a background of sky and clouds and a movie clip and then the graphic symbol we're going to get to in a second, but notice that we only have one frame and that one frame is not a motion tween. So if I test this movie, watch what happens. The movie clip is playing its internal timeline even though the main timeline has no animation and no frames in it other than the first frame. So movie clips play independent of the timeline. Graphic symbols are different. Graphic symbols depend on what you have happening on your main timeline. So let's go ahead and see how this will work. I'll go ahead and extend my, well, let's create the graphic symbol first. Now I don't want to have to create this all over again. So here's a handy trick for you. I'll go into the movie clip and I'll click, hold shift and click the last frame, right click and choose copy frames. I'll go back out to my scene and go to insert new symbol, and I'm going to make sure it's a graphic and call this GFC bird. And in that internal timeline, now you can see we're in the graphic symbol of bird. I can right click and do paste frames, so I didn't have to really do any of that work again. So let's go back out, and on the graphic symbol layer, I'll add that graphic symbol, and now let's test out the movie. As you can see, the movie clip plays because again its timeline is independent of the main timeline, but the graphic symbol just sits there, and that's because it depends on how many frames or what you have going on in the main timeline. Another way to look at this is if we extend the time that each of these layers lasts. So I'll go ahead and hit F5 to add more time, and for this graphic symbol I think I'm going to move it up so we can see it a little bit better. Now you can see that this one has smooth animation, but this one kind of looks erratic, and that's because it's only playing 5 frames of the actual 9 that were supposed to be in that motion. And you might see this better if I only, let's say, do 3. Okay, so again, it's only playing 3 out of the 9 that it could possibly have on the internal timeline. So you're probably wondering, why would you ever use a graphic symbol then? Well, let's go ahead and animate these birds so they move left to right. And I'll go ahead and remove these frames real quick. So for this one, I will do insert motion tween. And at frame 1, I'm going to have it start here. And by frame 24, I want it to move here. So that's a straight flying path for him. Same thing with this guy. I'm going to have him line up. Well, kind of. And insert motion tween. And by this point, I want him to be there as well. Okay. So let's add those. Watch it. And there we go. Let's go ahead and slow this animation down. Okay. So if we need to stretch this out, and I think we do, so we can see it even better, we'll go up to 100 frames. So there's 100, there's 100, and then F5. Okay. So now we're seeing that they both move and they both fly, and we didn't have to create frame by frame animation for the entire 100 frames because we only have 9 pictures. So we'd have to do 9 pictures, 9 pictures, 9 pictures all the way to 100, and it would just become tedious and you would hate animation. So let's go ahead and see why you would want to use a movie clip versus a graphic symbol and vice versa. Now the cool thing about a movie clip is that yes, it does play independent of the timeline, but it can also be targeted with ActionScript 3.0. In ActionScript 3.0, we can tell it to do something. We can tell it to fade in. We can tell it to drop in. We could tell it to loop or come back around. We can do all kinds of stuff with ActionScript. And with a graphic symbol, you can't target it with ActionScript. So again, we're kind of questioning, all right, why would I ever use a graphic symbol? Well, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go ahead and copy this movie clip. And we'll move him up here. And by this frame, let's have him going up here. And I could even, well, I don't need to make him smaller. And I can do another one. And this guy we can have up here. Oops. Here we go. Let's lock all these other ones because I'm getting confused. Oh, I must have copied the wrong one. Okay, we'll have him start back here, and by the last frame, have him end up here. So now we have our 3 movie clips moving at the top, and if I play this, no birds are ever in synchronization. So that just looks unnatural. Also, they're kind of hollow, so that looks unnatural too, but this doesn't give us natural motion. And there's no way to change that with a movie clip other than going in and breaking it apart and creating this a new movie clip, let's say movie clip bird 2, and changing the frame by frame animation. Not true with a graphic symbol. With a graphic symbol, we have this handy little looping feature in the properties panel. So let's see how that works for this one. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. So I'll move down to the new layer and lock that first one. And we're going to move this guy, let's say we'll put him back here, way back here, and by this point, I want him to be up here, and I'll probably do another one just to show a good example. So I'll take that one and copy it, and let's say I want to move that one down here. And have them kind of start a little bit further back. And by the end of the animation, I want him to end here. Now, if I go and watch this, all 3 of these guys are still in synchronization, but let's change that. I'll go back and click on this graphic symbol. And when we get into the properties panel, and there we go. It's going to ask you if you want to sync graphic symbols, and we don't want to do that. But now when we click on the symbol itself, it's going to ask us, do we want to loop it, play once, single frame, and what's the first frame it should start on? So let's have this guy start on frame 4, and we'll have this one start on frame, let's do 8, and now let's watch it. So now that looks much more natural because they're not in synchronization. Now this is just like really crowded. There's a lot of birds happening here. So with a graphic symbol, kind of think of it as true animation. You're not trying to do interactivity. You're not trying to program it or add action script. You're just trying to create animation that looks natural, and you want to maybe create a story or a skit with it. And then use a movie clip, and you're probably going to use movie clip most of the time, because when in doubt you should choose movie clip, because you don't want to create something as a graphic symbol and then realize later that you wanted to target it with action script. But with a movie clip symbol, you want to make it something maybe your main character you want to do as a movie clip symbol, because you know at some point you're probably going to target him or her with a action script. And that's the basics of working with movie clips and graphic symbols. You should try them out and try to figure out a good way to create something that's going to have a loop and have good animation without taking so much time and effort on your part, because that's truly what the power of the movie clip symbol and the graphic symbol is.